City Services. And welcome, Henry. And just, although it's clear to us that we're all present, I'll just ask the clerk to call the roll.
Counselor Bidwell?
Here.
Counselor Carney?
Present.
Counselor LaBarge?
Present.
Counselor O'Donnell?
Here.
Okay, and I don't see that there's any public comment, so I'll ask the members if there's a motion to approve the minutes from last week.
Move to approve.
Second.
Okay, moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Abstentions? Okay, thank you. So, Anne Marie, I guess you're on.
Okay.
And just you might want to introduce yourself. I think everybody knows you, but.
Yep, Anne Marie Moggio, the director of the Parks and Recreation Department. I handed out just a little synopsis of a couple of things I'll touch on today. I know there was a few specific questions that you had, and I'm sure maybe some other things will come up. Most of you have been involved with us over the years in some way or fashion with coaching or your kids or different committees and things. So right now, just to go over the first page there, our Park and Rec staff. We have seven of us full time. There's been quite a turnover in the past year or so with retirements and people leaving. So we have some new staff, some new, it's exciting, and we're in a new location. We are now located at JFK Middle School. We moved there from Smith Folk last July in the middle of the summer. So that proved to be interesting, but it's been a great move for all of us. We really like being at JFK where we are. It's right by the pool where we do a lot of the program, when we do the programming of the pool facility and the gym inside, and school's not in session, all the playing fields outside, and it's also been great to be so close to Look Park. So we're right there for where the majority of our summer camps are. So that's been, you know, being at Smith Folk didn't seem like we were really that far away, but being at JFK makes it even closer and even easier to do the programming and different things that we do there. So that's been a great move as far as we're concerned with the collaboration of the schools and the programs there. So on that first page also is our Park and Rec Commission, which you can see the members that are on there: Tom Dunphy, Glenn Conley, Mike Laga, Carol Bertrand, Dave Cronin, Dan Smith, Julia Chevin, and Kristen Dardano. And they're a great group. We actually have a meeting tonight. So they've been a great volunteer board, and they're an advisory board now, which changed last year since last time we met. But they still are very involved. Many of them are still on committees and work with us on the different parks and the projects and things we have. So they're still very involved, and it's a great partnership with them. So on the next page, just a little bit of, like I mentioned, where we operate. We're at JFK in our office now in a triple-wide or in a modular office, which is really nice. And like I mentioned, we don't have any programming facilities. Everything we do is inside the schools in the wintertime. So we work with the school department and all the different principals and things to use the buildings when the school isn't using them. We have a cooperative agreement with Look Park to do our summer camps, which we've had for over 25 years. And that's a great partnership and a wonderful facility in the summertime for our camps. And we couldn't do half the stuff we do without being able to be there with them. And they have a wonderful staff also. We also team up a lot with Wayne Fiden in the Office of Planning and Sustainability and the DPW, Parks and Cemeteries Division. The Parks and Cemeteries Division, the DPW, does all the maintenance of the facilities, outdoor facilities and bike paths and all of the city parks and playgrounds. I don't control, quote unquote, the maintenance staff, but we work collaboratively together to make sure things get done and in a timely fashion. We work on projects together. We team up when new things are happening and on renovations and building new facilities. So we have a great relationship with them also. And with planning, we do lots of grants and our most recent, everybody's aware of the Florence Recreation Fields up in Florence, which is an amazing addition to our city, and that opened a couple years ago, but we're on phase six coming up this summer, which is hard to believe, but we're going to be adding more of the rest of the playground there, some more netting that we need, some dugouts and scoreboards and some extra like benches and signage and things like that. So that park has been more of a hit than we could even have thought, especially the walkway around it. 3/4 of a mile, in case anybody's done it, and there's always people walking it with their dogs and biking it and playing on the fields and playing on the playground, and it's such a cool, cool spot. And that couldn't happen without our CPA grants and the state park grants, and then, like I said, the collaboration with all the departments that work together, and all of your commitment too and support. So that has been really fun. We've also been working with planning on the boathouse, the Connecticut River Greenway, Greenway River Boat Park, that's what they like to call it, down off of Damon Road. And that's an amazing, it's such a beautiful facility. That we are planning on getting a little more marketing out there this spring and working with the community rowing. With them some more this spring to get, you know, a little more of the public knowledge out there that you can bring your canoes and kayaks to launch there also. And they have a great program going there with everything they've been doing with their boathouse. So that's really fun and a great group to be working with. There'll be a little bit more work happening there this spring, and then we'll be ready to roll hopefully with all the signage there and get that project going.
Can I just ask a question about that?
Mm-hmm.
So once things are more fully developed in terms of programming there, who will be doing what? I mean, will you folks actually be operating?
We don't have current plans to do programs. We're teaming up with the community rowing group to sort of work with them, because they have the facility there and they have the knowledge and the people who can do it. So kind of like the how we work with all the other sort of nonprofits in the town too that offer programs. We assist with getting out marketing or the knowledge to the public of it. And then we also will be letting the public know that you can go there. Not, you don't have to take part in a program. You can just go there and, you know, launch your boat.
And can you store your kayak there now?
They will have, I believe they have some storage facilities that they're putting in, and where you can leave your kayak there and pay a certain fee per month.
So, but they'll manage all.
So, So, they're a very big, hardworking group that has done a lot down there, as you know. So, that's exciting. But yeah, I mean, and things could change. There could be probe times, or we teamed up with a couple other groups that down at the state area in the past. They offered programs for canoeing and the adaptive programs. Yeah, down there, we teamed up a few summers ago with them to offer programs. So. Kind of like we do it together and get it out there at an affordable price for people. So I see some of the same kinds of things happening in the future. So,
Anne-Marie,
options are open.
Do you also have people with disabilities or children with disabilities, and like at the boathouse, mm-hmm. right? Do you have children that you bring down to the boathouse who have disabilities or people?
We don't have specific programs that bring any of that down there. The next phase is putting in some docks that are more accessible,
okay.
and adding accessible docks there so that they can. So they're working on that right now. So that was just part of the CPA grant round that's happening now. So that will be
a
great addition. Any other questions on boathousing? So I guess, and then, you know, just sort of some of these, just outline some of the different programs that we do. And we use the school fields for programming as well as recreational fields that are owned by the city. The school owns many of the fields too. And we share those, the indoor spaces I mentioned, just lists a lot of the different programs that we do, and that we use the pool at JFK, which has been a great addition, which seems like it was just yesterday, but it was like 21 years ago already or something, the pool addition, which is crazy. So that's a really popular place too for our citizens to go to. Also, Museum and Beach, we operate up in Leeds. So last year the DPW did some renovations up there, or some additions to spruce it up, and we're doing a little bit more this spring up there to make that, you know, to make that look even nicer. And we have always had a lot of members and people visiting up there. It's a great spot for camps. Also, We collaborate with all different kinds of groups in the city, from offering like the community rowing, cycling club, Sugarloaf track. We team up with all the different, a lot of leagues are run by parent nonprofits, and we help them and guide them and give them fields and facilities and run programs with them. We also have scholarships so that anybody can take the programs. We really pride ourselves on keeping prices at really low compared to others around us. And we really try hard to do that, make things accessible, affordable, and so therefore we have different scholarship fundraising activities and things to keep the fees so that if somebody needs assistance, they're gonna get it. So we work with people as much as we can with that. There's also a new Friends of Park and Recreation Committee that has taken a couple years to form, but they are registered 501c3. So they have been meeting a couple times a month and are just about ready to launch their brochures to start focusing on their first activity is going to be phase 6 at Florence Fields to help get the playground in and those other amenities, the scoreboards and things like that. So they are, actually I think they're meeting next week. They're ready to hopefully get that going, and that's a great volunteer group too. That's always nice to have people who are willing to work with you to help raise money to get things for our city. I think that's, Pulaski Park also, we are not directly in charge of that renovation like most of the other parks we have been. The DPW is doing the renovations of the park, which you're probably aware of, and they're on the next phase, which is in the back here, the overlook phase, which is so cool. Park is so cool. We are going to be in charge of the programming of the park, as we are for all the other, pretty much all the other parks in town. We do all the programming and usage there. So we are in the process right now. I've been meeting with Brian Foote from the Arts Council, because he would obviously be doing a lot of programming and ideas and working with people from the public for different kinds of activities in the park. So we actually just met last week to come up with different ideas, and we're hopefully within the next couple weeks gonna have a more structured sort of outline plan to bring to the rest of people that are involved with the programming there. Try to get something finalized by mid-March. Well, wait, where are we? We're just the beginning of February. Yeah, end of February, because we're starting to get requests for summer usage, obviously. So we're working on that together. Anything else?
Yeah, one question. You talked about you have new staff in the recreation department.
Yes. Yeah. Chris Kostek, our secretary for 50 years now. Feels like it. She retired. Yeah. I know, it seems like she's only 30, but yeah.
I know, I didn't see her name.
Yeah. So Chris retired last July or so. Another one of our great staff we lost two of them that had been there for over 10 years. So it was a big, and Chris, which was like 20 years. So it was a big turnover last summer as we were moving. So we got some really great new people that are enthused and fun, and will be good. We do miss Chris.
Also, another question.
Mm-hmm.
With the senior center,
mm-hmm.
with Linda Desmond as the director down mm-hmm. there now, are there any plans of the rec department working with the seniors down there?
That's fine. I just saw her last week somewhere, and she goes, "We have to get together. I'll be ready in about another month to meet with you to talk about planning." So
good.
So yeah, I think she's settling in, and then she's going to be ready to launch hopefully some programming with us.
Great, thank you.
Yeah, that would be awesome down there. It's a great facility.
From year to year, is your sign up for your various summer camps and programs, is it pretty steady, growing? What are you seeing?
It is. I would say it's pretty steady. We have to change. We've changed things as there's so many offerings in this town, in this area. I mean, you can go to camp for pencil making. You can go for anything you can think of around here. There is something really cool to do. So our camps, instead of being so broad and just the general old fashioned camp, we've really changed with the times in terms of offering more specific themed type things, and that's really what parents seem to be looking for.
Mm-hmm.
And so we've really been able, we've really sustained our numbers by doing those kind of things and always trying to, okay, what are people looking for this year and what kinds of things? We've added a lot of, like, when I say camp, you can find camps for anything. We now do like Lego programs where you come in and work with Legos and things. Our summer day camps go on 3 or 4 trips a week to different, and there's so many cool places around here to go to the Gulf, to state parks, or go, you know, go kayaking somewhere, or canoeing, or things like that. So we really, our numbers have really pretty much stayed the same. And when something goes down a little bit, we'll add something else to, mm-hmm. you know, try to pique the interest.
I wondered how you, there's so much going on.
There is.
Every organization's got there. Huh? So I wondered how you,
yeah, we
you
added,
found your role in the middle of all that.
Yeah, so. I think we added a coding program, a art program, more specific, you know, half day or sometimes full day things to, you know, be additions to what our regular summer day camps are. So, and more options too. Like you can go 1 week now, or you used to have to sign up for 2, or you can, mm-hmm. you can do half days with this program, and then in the afternoons sometimes go to that. You know, go do tennis and so.
Are the summer programs pretty much financially self-supporting?
Yeah.
The fees basically
they're absolutely
cover everything?
They do. Yeah, the fees cover all the camp staff and supplies. And some of the full-time staff in our office too
mm-hmm.
are supported by fees from different programs. So
are there any scholarships for
yep.
city?
Absolutely. Yep. We have scholarships for, there's a lot of organizations around too that help families. So a lot of times they'll come into us already with, you know, 3/4 of, you know, sometimes they're coming in for, you know, they only need 1/4 of it and we can offer that and they're getting help from somewhere else. So people, there's a lot of places that people can go mm-hmm. for scholarships for camp. So it's nice.
I'd just like to say thank you for all your outstanding work and all the valuable programs you run. It was very impressive.
Well, thank you. Yeah. A lot of support in the city, so it's awesome. A lot of fun. All right.
Thank you.
All right, if you think of anything
thank
else,
you.
Let me know.
Okay,
thanks
very much.
Thanks. Okay, do you want to follow
up? Sure. Okay. Thank you.
Because it's colorful and pretty.
Yeah. Now, we don't have any agenda to touch, maybe we can wait until the end to future meetings, but there's some calendar. Was it you personally that always said an 8 meeting out there with you?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, I know I'm not going to be here, so on that first week of April, so we need to do some schedule.
It's actually number 6 on your agenda.
It is. Very good. Okay. So why don't we go right on to the next item, which is the appointments that were referred from the January 19th meeting. And so we had 4 appointments. We had Booker Bush. Is that you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Booker Bush has expressed interest in serving on the Human Rights Commission. I spoke with him last week. He's a physician by background. Works in Springfield. Has been throughout his medical teaching career focused on community-based care and sort of the world where human rights, civil rights, medical care all intersect. So he brings that perspective to the Human Rights Commission. He's sat in on a couple of meetings of the commission. He's very enthusiastic about it, and I think he'll add a great perspective to that commission, and he's a really outstanding guy. So we're lucky that he stepped up.
Okay, and should we take these all as a group? Probably,
sure.
Okay. Then for the Arts Council, Councilor
Dow? Yeah, I talked to Ms. Murray And she currently works at the Montessori School and has been in the area for a long time. And I think she just has an interest in the arts and seeing it succeed locally. When I spoke to her, she mentioned one of her principal interests is bringing more people into some of the local arts programs we have, including more young people. And as someone works, who works at a school, I think that's a valuable background to bring to what's very real need. So I think she did a great job, and I'm happy to recommend her personally.
I spoke with Samuel Taylor, who was a nominee to the planning board. He was very interested in serving on the planning board, has been a resident for maybe 7 years, said that he could bring his experience. He does property management, I guess is primarily the related field. He also runs a small business, a laundromat. But he thinks that he can bring that the small business and the property management perspective to issues as they may arise on the planning board. And I thanked him for his being willingness to serve and said that I would be supporting a positive recommendation. And so the zoning board?
Maureen Scanlon, zoning board. I met Maureen way back a few years ago, which the mayor had a task force involved with the Florence Grammar School. And she was highly involved on that task force and charged with determining the fate of the old Florence Grammar School building. She did find it to be challenging, productive, and a rewarding process. She also felt that contributing through her ability to listen to all parties without bias and ask meaningful questions, to consider the practical needs of the city and assist in the ultimate decision as a representative of the city. So she feels that she would be highly experienced in relation to the ZBA laws and so forth. She has been living here in Northampton since 1981 and she came from Vermont. She's highly involved in the politics here in the city also, and she's a strong supporter of our local government. She's attended many, many forums and so forth, but she feels that her father was a city councilor also in another state, and she learned a lot from him also on zoning and her being a graphic designer herself. Being involved, like she is here in the city of Northampton, in being involved in committees to deal with zoning, that she feels that she would really like to be approved to be on the zoning.
Okay. Well, I'll ask then if there is a motion to send these four names with a positive recommendation to the full council.
I would make that motion to forward these.
And seconded?
Yeah.
Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Not opposed.
Okay. And then the abstentions? Okay, then.
I voted aye.
I guess it's unanimous. Okay. All right, and then we have two other appointments that were referred to us on February 2nd. Councilor LaBarge has indicated an interest in speaking with Deborah Epstein. And is there any interest to speak with? Does anyone know Pauline Vogel?
Sure. I'd be glad to speak to you.
Oh, okay, thank you.
Who's doing that one?
So, Councilor Bidwell will speak with Pauline Vogel, reappointment to the Historic Commission. All right, then we have item six is our discussion about future meetings. And one of which is a schedule conflict that I have for the first week in April.
Right, I did talk to Brad LeBay, and they are scheduled to come in March. I told them about it.
Okay.
And they will come in with a schedule of the events that they have going on from whenever, May on, up until the fall. And he'll be coming in with, what's his name?
Well, Steve Connor with city staff?
Huh?
Steve Connor?
I don't know.
Is Steve's coming in?
Okay.
Yep, I ran that one by the mayor's office. But I do need to get back with them about questions that you'd like to have the Veteran Services Department respond to, so.
Beyond departmental update. Okay, so maybe we can generate those here if people have some specific questions
For Steve?
Steve Connor and the Veteran Services Department?
Yeah, it's usually like his budget and so forth, how they're doing in the outer areas. That's always been a great concern, and the homeless veterans.
Got those. Any other specific questions or topics you'd like to see discussed beyond their general scope?
Just the status of the homeless veteran initiative that the mayor is working with that department.
Okay. Is that good?
Yep.
And then, we could go ahead with the April meeting on that date, if Councilor LaBarge, if you think that you're going to be, she's having some medical issues too. So I'm essentially going to be away that week. We could reschedule?
Can we reschedule another day?
To the following week?
Oh.
So I just wanted to bring to your attention that you're going to be coming up on budget meetings.
Oh, yeah.
So you just had the IT department come in and talk about their consolidation.
At the council, yeah.
The mayor's having the IT department come in and talk to you about something that was on your agenda this past week.
Correct.
Is there something specific that you'd like to have covered with the IT department? Because
otherwise.
No, we could skip them.
Skip them.
I think let's forego that presentation.
Okay.
And we could either meet with another department. Well, we may have, it's the way it's been going with dozens and dozens of appointments, it's likely that we'll need to meet to deal with some appointments. So would folks be interested in trying to meet the following week?
Right. Do you know when the budget hearings are going to be? Because we don't have them in April.
Right. They'll be probably between mid and the end of May.
Yeah.
Right. So are you asking about moving it to April 10th from April 3rd?
April 10th, but I think that that's also is that a legislative matters date?
The second Monday?
Yeah, but we could, if we met at our usual time, it wouldn't conflict, right?
Yeah, that's fine, yeah.
Is it possible for us to meet, Pam, on the 10th instead of
the 3rd? Did you say meets at 5?
They meet at 5, right?
So we could probably meet at 4.
Yeah.
Okay.
On the 10th.
Particularly if we're not doing a presentation, we just have a couple of
right, and we may just have appointments. Okay.
So we're doing the 10th?
We're going to do the 10th. At 4 o'clock.
Or 4:30. If we have no presentation.
There you go.
Just at 5. If it's inconvenient for anybody, 4 o'clock is fine.
Well, why don't we see, we'll know as we get closer how many appointments we have to deal with.
Okay.
Very good, thank you. So
April 10th.
It's 4 with a question mark.
Okay.
Thank you. And then we have the possibility of having a meeting in May that would focus around the opioid crisis in Northampton.
Mm-hmm.
And we know that we would, we have had this presentation from the health department specifically in the past, but we talked about seeing if there were ways that we could see how multiple departments may be working on this specific program, issue. So we would want to maybe have Meredith from the health department.
In the police department?
EMS or EMS?
Would that be fire rescue?
Yeah, fire rescue, right. Used to be EMS. And police? So would that be a way to communicate with the mayor's office to have folks from those three to come to a May meeting and say that we'd like them to address the issue of the opioid crisis?
Okay, so would it be fair to say that you'd like the health department to give you an update on Hampshire Hope?
Sure, yes, please.
And then fire rescue to bring information about statistics?
Yes.
For
incidents, I guess, opioid overdose related calls.
Okay.
Innovative or ways to respond.
Okay. And what about the police?
Yeah.
I think that a lot of this is regional and coordinated to the DA's office, and I think they may work. So perhaps they could speak to the regional programs that they're involved with.
Would it make sense to reach out to the DA's office to ask them?
Yeah, the district attorney's office.
Yeah.
Mary Carey could set up something.
Yeah, I'm sure they have community liaisons.
Yeah, well, Lori Lozelle is doing that now, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we'll try to be in touch with Lori Lozelle at the district attorney's office.
It might be good to inform the public more than we usually do about our meetings, maybe actively promote, since it's such a topic of interest. Mm-hmm. I don't know if we'll get many members of the public to attend, but it's certainly, I think it's worthwhile to tell people that the city council is looking at this issue closely.
Mm-hmm.
As we get closer to.
Yeah. I'll just ask folks, I won't be at the April council meeting, so if someone can bring it up then.
Yeah.
April council or this meeting?
Both. I'm going to be gone that week.
Okay.
So we took care of the day we're going to meet the following Monday.
Good. Yeah.
Okay.
Sounds like a plan.
Anything more?
Sounds good.
Okay. Is there another motion?
Okay.
Second, all those in favor?
Aye.